So what we're going to do today is make the buttercream icing. This is a variation of the Wilton buttercream icing, which is actually a very flavorful icing, and it's very versatile. It's also easy to spread and to work with for piping and making cake decoration purposes. That's why we're doing it. Okay, the normal buttercream icing does not have meringue powder in it. And this is meringue powder, and I have it in the refrigerator for you guys for tomorrow. What the meringue powder does, it's egg whites that have been pasteurized and dried out so that they're easy to work with. So this will last a while. Depending on which icing we make with it, we can either not refrigerate it or refrigerate it to store it. The one that we're making today and tomorrow, we really should refrigerate it, okay? And we can refrigerate this for up to 6 weeks. We can also freeze it for up to 6 weeks, and then we can also reuse it again, okay? The first thing that we're going to do is, your recipe is for 6 cups, okay? So when you're gonna make a full recipe for your kitchen, and each one of your group members is going to get 3 cups. We're gonna make 3 different consistencies out of that 3 cup, okay? So the first thing that you need to do is, can you see in there, we have 2 cups of Crisco or shortening. And we're just gonna start at slow speed and work our way gradually to like a medium. And we just wanna cream that, get it all nice and softened. And to that, we are going to add our extract. Now this is versatile because I can make this a buttercream by having half Crisco and half butter for my measurements. Instead of 1 cup of Crisco or 2 cups of Crisco, I can have 1 of Crisco and 1 of butter. And it's gonna give that butter flavoring. I can also use right now I'm putting in vanilla extract, but for wedding cakes, a lot of times what they'll add is almond extract, or they'll add lemon juice. Put it in there. Anyway, okay. I can add all kinds of different extracts if I want, just to change the flavor. I don't have to stick with just vanilla. That a quick whip, and there it is. All right, so as you can see, there's a lot that's on sides and down on the bottom that may not have been whipped, so I just want to quickly give that a turn or a scrape to get it loose. All right, so if you look at your recipe, we have the fat in there, we have the vanilla, we also have 1/4 cup of water, but we're not gonna add that straight away. Then we also need the powdered egg whites, or the meringue powder. Now, powdered egg whites and meringue powder are a little bit different. The meringue powder is more stable, it's easier to, it lasts longer in the storage process. And it also makes a sturdier flour when we use it for cake decorating. And I'm gonna add that in now. So I have 2 tablespoons of that. Okay, and this will also, in our icing, it'll also help it to harden and stiffen a little bit, as opposed to a buttercream will stay soft a lot longer. Now, if I went and made a royal icing, which is no fat and just the meringue powder with the powdered sugars and the liquids and the extracts, that's where, I don't know if you ever had them, those really hard pieces of decorated candy that people put on cakes and cupcakes, like different shapes, that's the royal icing. So it helps with that. Okay, so I have that in. I'm gonna add a pinch of salt. And since this is a very sweet icing, because the recipe that we're using here today takes one whole bag, 2 pounds of flour, powdered sugar. So I'm gonna help cut the sweetness a little bit by using a pinch of salt. Now I could also, if I wanted to use butter, I could also use salted butter. That'll help cut that sweetness down a little bit. Okay, so I have that in. Now I have to add in my powdered sugar. Now this is where it gets messy. Okay, I'm gonna add it in a little bit at a time. Now you can do it as videos and recipes suggest by adding it a cup of time. And it doesn't have to be exact because we already know the measurement in this bag is what we need. Now what happens if I add dry ingredients to this? Are we okay yet? Good? Okay. What's gonna happen as soon as I turn this on? It's gonna poof. It's gonna, as Liam says, poof. And I think there's a little bit more technical term for it, but we'll go with poof. You can use a damp cloth or you can just use a dry cloth to get rid of the poof. Okay? Just until it's incorporated in. Okay, so you could measure it one cup at a time, or you could do what I like to do since I know I'm gonna use the whole bag, is I am just going to put a little bit in at a time, incorporate it. Give it a little boost. Okay, and I want to make sure I incorporate all of the powdered sugar. And then I want to make sure that it is to the consistency that I want. Now, I still have liquid to add. And as you see, it's getting thicker. I don't know, can you guys see up there? Okay. Now, I'm going to wait till the end to add my liquid in. Still good? Someone just beat me. Oh, okay. Okay, what I'm gonna be making is a stiff consistency, which is if you like things like roses on your cakes, this would be perfect for that. Anything that needs something that's really formed and has to hold its shape. Still have a little bit more to go. Okay, and you can see that that's bright white. If I would have had butter, it would have been slightly a tinge to it, not exactly the bright white that you see here. It is getting thicker, it's getting messier. And we still have a little bit of powdered sugar to add. About a cup's worth. Just gonna push that down. And every once in a while, make sure that you scrape and loosen it from the paddle attachment that we're using. Why do you think we should not use the whisk?
It's gonna get stuck.
It's gonna get stuck. Okay, and I said that it's going to be thick and that we're going to add our liquids at the end. Are we still good?
Yeah, can I just join the Zoom so I can see them?
Yeah, I don't care. Guess you want to Zoom? Or is she getting it for you? I am gonna post this, so. Okay, can you hear that it's rattling and that it sort of sounds like it's getting a little tough in there? Okay, if you're using like a handheld mixer at home or an old mixer like this, if you hear that it's starting to labor, what you can do is instead of waiting to the end to add your liquid, you can start adding it a little bit at a time. And that will help with the consistency so that it's thinner, so that it wouldn't be so tough on the mortar or the machine. And you can see it makes pretty much. I said we're gonna have about 6 cups when you guys are done. So each group member is gonna get 3 cups to learn how to decorate with. Okay, so right now we got thick, and we're gonna start adding our liquid, and I have 1/4 cup of water. Now the buttercream recipe that I use uses milk. But using water also helps with the shelf life of it. If you use milk, like I do at home, and I use soy milk, regular milk, almond milk, whatever kind of milk I have at home. Depending on the type of milk you have, it's gonna add some fat to it, it's gonna add to the flavor to it. So it's versatile in that way also. And you can see it's starting to get a little bit thinner. And we'll do a scrape down. And this is a very sweet icing. Okay, so I have that. I have a little bit more liquid to add. I think I've got, is that Liam? Did you add them? Okay, so when you add liquid, something else to think about is the humidity in the room. Is it a warm day? You're going to maybe need less liquid to get the consistency that you want. If it is a cooler day, a dry day, it might take the amount that you're that's required. You good? I don't think you're getting this feed, Liam. You're gonna get whatever's on the computer.
Yeah, I can't see the top.
Okay. All right, so this is a thick consistency. Like I said, this is for things like roses. Okay, now what I wanna do is, you guys are going to save 1 cup each. So that means that out of this, since it's only me, I'm gonna save 2 cups. And you want to label it thick. Okay, I actually have enough containers that you guys will will get your own container for each one of the consistency. All right, so that's my thick. And when we're done with this, we're going to throw it away. You're not going to play with it and eat it, okay? So then I want to get a different consistency. And there is a medium. So what I need to do is I am going to thin this down. So if I want to thicken it up, I'm going to add powdered sugar. If I want to thin it down, I'm going to add my liquid. Okay? Okay, and if you look, it says border flowers with petals, which is not the roses. Anything that lays down flat on your cake, you're going to use it. It says add 1 teaspoon of water. This is my teaspoon. Okay, and we're going to beat that. Okay, and you're going to take 2 cups out of that. Okay, so there'll be a cup for each of your members. And I don't know if you can tell just by seeing it as I scoop it, the difference in consistency. Okay, so that is a slightly thinner. Okay, so now we need to go even thinner because we always put an inscription on cakes, or we might need to draw lines or vines of flowers on a cake. And we need that to be soft and flowing. So we're gonna add another teaspoon. Okay, and this one will be the easiest to get out of the pastry bag and the tips that we use. And we need it to basically flow, because when you write or do an inscription, bless you, or you do vines of a flower, they need to flow without breaking. It needs to be a continuous line. I get this out. So you'll each get 2 cups of that. All right, so now this icing will develop a skin over it, a light skin. And what you need to do is to prevent that from happening is to cover it. And you want to place your saran wrap, or you can use a damp cloth if you're working with it, but don't make it soaking wet because that'll add more moisture to it and ruin it. The consistency. But what you want to do is we're going to cover it with cling film right on top of it, the icing. If you have it right on the surface, it can't develop that skin or that film, that crust that's going to get on top of it. Okay? So you need to have it right on top. When you peel it off, it's just going to come right off. So you're not going to lose anything. Okay? When we put it inside of our pastry bags, I'll show you that method tomorrow after you make your icing before we start decorating. I'll show you a trick on how to wrap it up in the cling film and then insert it into your tube so it's less messy. Okay. Once it's in your pastry bags, we'll be able to put it into a Ziploc baggie if you'd like, or if you'd like to empty it into a container, a separate container, we'll also do that. You can do, just make sure that you label it tomorrow, okay?